So welcome back. We are going to have a look at a stabilization pond and a septic tank. Basically, this is nothing but your oxidation pond. And this stabilization pond is one of the oldest treatment processes. One of the oldest treatment processes which have been used. In fact, you just go and put stuff into the oxidation pond. Things take care of themselves. And there are various steps, like how it settles down, how the sludge gets compressed at the bottom, because as more and more sludge comes on top, the weight of the new sludge will press the old sludge down. Indirectly, there's a little dewatering, getting squeezed, water comes out, and the sludge on top is bigger, so water can squeeze through those pores. So all these things do happen. Stabilization ponds are used both for industrial as well as for domestic waste. Okay. And ideally, this is also an aerobic process. They even call it an oxidation pond. This is a typical layout. Okay, this is a typical layout where you have the influent brought in here. Okay, and there is a baffle wall so that things just don't go as they like. There's a very deliberate slowing down before it can go to the second part. And here you can manage the height by using this adjustable overflow weirs. That means at different levels they have pipes, so which pipe you open will determine the level over here. Okay. And you can see the different pipes which are there. This is a cross section, and basically you just ensure that the water to be treated is there in certain, like, you know, it has the required length of time. So here you are. Facultative. This is the word I was trying to bring out. Okay. Aerobic, facultative, and you have also the aerated ponds. So what does this mean? Facultative means facultative ponds will have facultative bacteria, which are nothing but bacteria that can live in both aerobic and anaerobic conditions. Okay. So you have aerobic ponds which are usually which can also get oxygen from photosynthesis. How can it get oxygen from photosynthesis? You put some plants, plankton and all that. They eat up the matter. For them, the metabolism gives oxygen. We give out carbon dioxide. Plants give out oxygen. Basically, so that is one thing of doing it. Okay, and it means that throughout the pond, at all levels of the pond, you'll be able to get oxygen. However, you will sometimes require some additional oxygen also to be put in. Like, only the surface oxygen might not be sufficient. So there you will do, like, you know, may have paddles, or you might have some any other thing, like even your compressed air. Whatever method you want to do, you can still do it. Okay. Little off track. Actually, potassium permanganate is an oxidizing agent. Okay. So how it does all its work of purification is because it oxidizes the stuff. Anyway, that's just offhand. So these are some of the design criteria for the oxidation pond. Okay, so you have some bottom material, you got a dike material, you got some freeboard which you have to worry about. What is freeboard? What is above the
level?
Above the level, yes, water level. And then the liquid depth. See, the liquid depth means, if suppose it's very deep, our surface oxygen cannot reach the bottom. So you will have to think about that. Number of cells, number of units in parallel which it works in. Now you just have a look at this video of an oxidation pond. The oxidation pond is there in the background. Okay, you can see the oxidation pond in the background. No. Don't worry, because if you don't are not familiar with Hindi, it'll be a big bore. It's a nice report, but it's in Hindi. Okay, now coming back here, you can see the big tank in the background. Okay, and very briefly, the second part of the tank from where you can draw the material scene. But basically here, this is an aeration system. what happens here, the aeration removes the floating substances, it makes it float to the top. The scum is being removed. And here is a picture of the septic tank. So this is the typical septic tank. You have one baffle in the middle. So you will always find that water is there at one particular level. Okay, so minimum some level water has to be there. Inside that you have the sludge. Even a septic tank will have to be seeded. That is the initial, when you are starting the septic tank, some waste from another septic tank has to be brought in, put in before it actually starts to become effective. Okay, so this is the effluent which is getting removed, and usually here you will also have, depending on the type of septic tank, you don't need to have a the wall at the bottom. Okay, it will just it's called a soak pit. Okay, so actually what happens is effluent which is coming out, it can be put into the soak pit, so it will just get absorbed by the ground. Okay, you don't need to take it actually out to into the open, or you don't have to take it for subsequent treatment. And because this process will release a lot of gases, you should ensure that it is, those gases are vented into the atmosphere. If you remember, this septic tank is also very dangerous. You should remember that here also pockets of methane gas can be created. Okay, earlier they used to use buckets and remove the sludge in bullock carts, but now people are using those vacuum trucks, which is nothing but a truck with a motor, or the motor, and it will just suck out all the things, and then it will take the sludge and it's getting disposed. Unfortunately, I have seen so many of these trucks, including the municipal trucks, discharging this waste into water bodies without any treatment. Okay, which is very bad. So in fact, half of our pooms or rivers are starting only because of such process. Our problem is, people will say we have to go all the way to the waste disposal plant, which is so many kilometers away. They don't want to do it. If they see something, just like how they take a leak, you know, at the bus stops, they immediately get down behind the bus. Like that, these fellows also take off the highway and dispose everything. And it's very, very bad and very, very shameful. So friends, now okay, basically this sums up the settling tank. Now what has happened is, my slideshow, there had been some problem, so the septic tank image which I had has gone. But basically, you know what a septic tank is. Actually, septic tank is more of a primary treatment, it's not exactly a secondary treatment. Inside a septic tank, you have got settling happening. You've got an anaerobic digestion that's taking place, and again you just decant all the liquid from the top.
Anaerobic?
Yes, septic tank is anaerobic. You close it, no? You don't open it.
Can we keep a small pipe like thing on the?
No, that is only to take out all the gases. Okay, because when you are.
That's open.
That doesn't give as much oxygen as you require for. And it's just that, see, if you look at, I didn't bring that. There is a person who is having a pork farm in America. So he has a lot of those animals, and all the waste from the manure from that, okay, or excreta from that, he takes and puts it into a biogas reactor. On top of that, he has a thick plastic film, tarpaulin-like sheet. He is able to walk on it. What is below it is that methane gas which is holding it in pressure. So all such gases are released out. Otherwise, they will all accumulate and you don't know what can happen. And it's basically that bad smelling gases which have to go out, that for which they give that more like a pressure relief system. It is not going to give any oxygen worth mentioning. Okay. So I am stopping this lecture now.